This conference is trying to understand why growth has been so low for so long. The previous session showed that mismanagement cannot explain it all. So we were looking here at the factors and the role of demand policies. We were on the demand side. And we had two professors from Pompeu Fabra Universitat in Barcelona, and they highlighted the role of fiscal policy for one and of monetary policy, if I may say, for the other one. While the third speaker, Benoît Mejon, from the Banque de France, had a longer term perspective and allowed other factors and other policies to have a role in the process. The main idea would be that in the short run, monetary policy may have a role, but it is very soon overburdened. Then fiscal policy, as is known now and called for, can help, in particular, thanks to the paper by Luca, to spur and to stimulate innovation. And in the longer run, we definitely see that other factors on the supply side have to be taken into account, demographics, productivity also, and inequalities, and this is something which will be looked at in the next session.
Because when growth is weak, consumers don't want to spend, and aggregate demand and employment are high. But when profits and aggregate demand are low, firms don't want to invest, and productivity growth is low. And hence, there is this vicious cycle between aggregate demand and productivity growth that can lead to long periods of stagnation. And then the question is, which kind of policy intervention can lift the economy out of stagnation? And what we find is that one policy intervention that can do the job is subsidy to innovation, because subsidy to innovation fosters future growth process, induce consumers to spend more, and can drive the economy out of these stagnation traps.
That one should not discard the possibility of a money-financed fiscal stimulus. I have shown that it's effective in the sense of having large effects on output and positive effects on inflation. It's effective both in normal times, when there are no constraints on the possibility of reduction in interest rates, as well as in circumstances in which the economy is at the zero lower bound and the interest rate cannot be lowered.
One of the main forces of real interest rates, one of the most successful forces to explain both the decline in real interest rates, which have dropped by about 4% over the last 25 years, is a change in the preference of investor, or a change in the perception of investor who seem to be more risk adverse. So they're really desperate to hold a larger proportion of their wealth as safe assets, and they're ready to have a very low, very small return, a very small interest rate on those safe assets.